Well, I must say it was much easier getting here today. There were no cows. Honestly. Although the geometric storms do seem to be ramping up rather at the moment. Do you remember last time I said I would tell you about Lady Blossomberry? Just delve in and find out. She's quite an interesting character. Lady Blossomberry was the only daughter to Brina the Red, sister to the Queen of the Valley at the time of the second moon in Neptune, Rosebud the Red. In other words, Queen Lilibell's cousin. She had been raised in the royal palace and, although was aware of all her royal privileges, had shied away from as much royal protocol as she could and immersed herself in her studies. To her, books were a way of escaping the palace walls. As they took her on adventures she could have only ever wished to go on. With pictures and places that ignited excitement in her soul. Her tutor, Mrs. Skinnythorn, had been most impressed with Blossom's talent in magic and fairy lore and was sure that her next assignment to learn the fairy skills of levitational travel would be another educational success. Now, Lady Blossomberry, today, as we look at levitational powers, I want you to actually visualise yourself in the action of levitation as though it is second nature to you. Do you understand? Said Mrs. Skinnythorn, as she scribbled levitation on the blackboard behind them. I shall return at noon rise to find out how you've been getting on. And with that, Mrs. Skinnythorn picked up her books and chalk and left the classroom with the door clunking shut behind her. It was just another day in the life of Blossom. She hardly saw anyone, and books were her escapism and means to finding the things that she longed to see, but feared she would never have the opportunity to, as she was a royal. And royals were not allowed to exceed in adventurous magic of any kind. She opened the first page in the book in front of her called Levitation for All, and it immediately floated slowly up to her eye level. Goodness, exclaimed Blossom. She had never seen a book levitate before. As she slowly read through the pages, she became particularly transfixed on a small chapter about parallel travel and imagined how wonderful it would be if she could master such a thing. She would be able to visit all the places in the books she had seen and only dreamt of. And so, although not part of today's lesson, she spent quite some time reading up on the complexities of the art. But not wanting to deviate too far away from the topic of the day's lesson, she went back to the pages on levitation and continued with what she had been assigned to. It was by far her most favourite subject to date, and by the time the clock was almost at noonrise, she had levitated around the classroom nearly 50 times. Goodness me. She was having so much fun that she didn't hear the door open and Miss Skinnythorn return. Will you get down at once, Lady Blossomberry? You are not allowed to practice in such a manner without a chaperone. Although I am glad to see you understand the basic principles of the subject, said a stern Miss Skinnythorn, as she walked to the front of the room and took out her chalk and wrote chaperone on the blackboard. Tomorrow we shall go on to the next level, but for now you may go. Blossom stood up from her desk and left the classroom for her chambers, tightly clutching her new book. That night in her room, she tried to sleep, but all she could do was think about levitation, especially the chapter on parallel travel. She imagined all the adventures she could have. It was as though she felt she was already able to master it. She lit the candle by her bed and opened the book. The chapter on parallel travel fell open as if it was waiting for her to read it. She peered over the top of the floating book and read a part of the chapter out loud. In order to use parallel travel for the purposes of travelling to another realm, and for it to be successful, The participant must first imagine the place they wish to travel to from accordingly, picture it fully, and imagine their toes on the ground and the objects around them in their mind's eye to be real, thus becoming real. First-time participants may need several attempts. This is not a subject for the novice levitator. Sounds simple enough, said Blossom, ignoring the last sentence, and then remembered that she hadn't actually been anywhere other than the palace grounds, so imagining anywhere else could be very difficult, and she certainly didn't fancy visiting the royal kitchens or gardens in the middle of the night. But not to be defeated, she got out of bed and took down a book from her bookcase about the Black Mountains. She loved the pictures of the majestic mountainous plains and would often look at them. She closed her eyes tightly and imagined them all, seeing the pictures from the book and trying to feel the cold mountain air with her nose. But nothing happened. Oh, well, thought Blossom. And she sat down on her bed and looked at all the pictures again longingly. How beautiful she'd thought them to be, and wished with all her heart that one day she could go there. Then, quite unexpectedly and completely out of the ordinary, something quite miraculous happened. One minute she was in her chambers on her bedspread, and the next she could feel cool wind through her hair and the distinct smell of snow. Looking up, she saw peaks of snow-laden mountains covered with thick forests and clouds thicker than cotton balls. She gasped and stood up. Blossom had managed to levitate away from the palace into another realm through parallel travel quite by accident. Quite amazing. Quite astonishing, actually. Yes, I know. Goodness, she exclaimed, more excited than she had ever been before. I'm free. And so started a brand new chapter in the life of Lady Blossomberry. Finding her newfound freedom was the most amazing thing to have ever happened to her, albeit a forbidden one for such a royal fairy. And oh, how much trouble she would be in if anyone were to find out. Oh dear. Blossom soon took to travelling to all the places in the books she had read about, but always at night, while the palace slept, so she wouldn't get caught. She visited the elves of the Whispering Caves in the Elvian realm, and the opulent opals with its lush evergreens and vibrant flowers and tumbling waterfalls. Blossom was the happiest she had ever been, and for now, her secret levitational adventures were hers and hers alone. Her studies went from very good to absolutely brilliant and extraordinary. Mrs. Skinnythorn was most impressed at how diligent her student had become and thought it was time to introduce her to a more difficult subject. So when her tutor brought in another book on levitation, Blossom could hardly contain her excitement. She gently opened the cover of the book, which read Speed Levitation, and it hovered above the desk before her as if willing her to succeed in yet another difficult subject. Now, Lady Blossomberry, this is a subject you should know about, but we'll never have to use, so we will not be having practical lessons in it. Besides, it would be inappropriate for a lady of the royal court to be doing such a thing, said Miss Skinnythorn, as she wrote no practical lessons on the blackboard behind them. Blossom was not impressed. She didn't see the point in learning things she couldn't use. No, I have to agree. And decided that no one would know if she taught herself. Oh dear. So she started practicing by herself every night. But it was a difficult subject to master, as there was so much space needed for speed. The opulent opals were awkward, as the flowers were so large they got in the way and she kept flying into them. And the rough terrain of the Black Mountains was out of the question. And the whispering elves would probably not appreciate all the dust clouds in their narrow caves. So no, she would have to find somewhere else to practice. So she took to her books to try and find somewhere. She finally found a book on the flatlands, and its long desert-like stretches, surrounded by trees and woodlands. This was sure to be ideal for speed travel, and Blossom excitedly prepared herself for a trip later that night. However, foolishly and somewhat naively, she had overlooked that the flatlands were home to very big and very unfriendly trolls. Oh dear, dear, dear. That night she waited for the last flame to be blown out and the palace to be fast asleep. She picked up her book and began to imagine herself on the flatlands. Sure enough, before too long she was amongst trees, and to her left, through a clearing, she could see the largest stretch of open land she had ever seen or imagined. So that's why they call this place the Flatlands, she said as she pushed her way through branches to get to the dusty brown earth. It truly was a sight to be seen, as the plains went on for miles and miles. She was soon experimenting and levitating and practicing what she had learnt. She was so intent on mastering the tricky subject she had set herself that she was oblivious to the fact that the whole time she was there, she was being watched. Yes, watched. Behind the tree's camouflage, trolls were watching. This strange tiny creature was appearing and disappearing, jumping in the air and floating, causing the dust from the ground to make puffs in the air like smoke signals. And they were not happy for the intrusion. Trolls are suspicious by nature and never keen to socialise with anyone outside their own kind. They were born with warriors' hearts and would never be afraid to defend their territory at any cost. Blossom was unaware of the danger that lurked so close by. And before she had time to realise that she was not alone, it was too late. Oh, those are the calling birds. I shall have to go. But I know you shall want to come back and find out what on earth happens to poor Blossomberry. She's got herself in a little bit of bother, I think. Anyway, until then, take care. And remember, don't stop believing. Especially in you.